Pop off, bitch.
Wait, why all the hate all of a sudden?
I'm gonna kill your whole generation.
What's going on here? What game are we playing today?
Well, I found a crystal skull today, and it possessed me with the ghost of 50 Cent.
Oh my goodness.
And now my skull is gone. Not this skull, the
crystal
skull.
That's why you were telling me to hang out at the Jeep this morning.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I have to recreate the events of 50 Cent Blood in the Sand by midnight tonight, or else I die. It's the next game. It's the next game he's working on. Yeah.
All right. So
we're playing 50 Cent Blood in the Sand today.
Hi, I'm Alex Mejia, video producer here.
Hi, I'm Josh Stinson. I'm the video production assistant.
And what can you tell me about this game? That's it's kind of got an interesting history, right?
Yeah. So
this switch game, over so they can see the video roll too, because it's like kind of ridiculous.
So this game, I can't remember the name, but this eventually was published by old THQ.
Yes.
But somebody else was going to publish it before then.
It was Sierra was going to publish it, and then this is one of the games that they dropped when they did that restructuring.
Yeah.
Back in like 2007, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's eventually got brought over to old THQ with a couple other things, I think, at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
This is probably one of the most fucking absurd games in the entire universe, in a really good way. Like, it's not just like a, haha, you know, like, this game's stupid. Like, it is stupid, but it's also actually fun to play.
No, like, it's a good, it's like
it's a
good,
decent game.
It's
like
a pretty solid third-person shooter.
I would say this is, like, one of those really good, like, you don't know anything about it games. It's not, like, something you get hyped up for and then you bought it. It's just like, oh, you found it at Target. It was $15. You got it, and it was awesome.
It's definitely like a pizza on a Friday night.
Yeah.
It's like, it's not like it's going to be amazing or that it's good for you.
Yeah, it's
But it's a
fun.
Really, it's a really good time.
Yeah.
It's a really good time.
Yeah, 50 Cent rules. This game owns.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. We'll start the game here. It has actually quite an amazing setup.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we're gonna go ahead and do a new game here. And we'll play a I forget, is this game hard?
Not really. Normal's fine.
Just do normal. Okay. And we're gonna play co-op here in just a second. But, actually, you get to pick... I had to pick who you were going to be. So, do you want to be Tony Yayo?
I mean,
Lloyd Banks or DJ Woo Kid?
I play this game a shitload for the internet. I have to be Tony Yayo because he has the best swears in the game.
Oh my goodness! All right, so there's gonna be this crazy cutscene that plays here. I seem to remember the
cutscenes
for
this game are awesome too.
Yeah, I remember the setup for this game is pretty amazing.
I don't know who wrote this. Okay, so there are
50 Cent. He wrote everything. He's on the box, dude.
He did in an interview. He did say this movie was inspired by the movie Blood Diamond. He did.
It's the last hour of the show tour. 50 Cent is getting ready to walk off stage.
He just fucking drops the mic immediately.
Yeah, that's his whole show right there.
There was
that's
no
it.
Concert. He just came out on stage, dropped the mic, and that's all you get.
Isn't he also doing his last show?
In yeah, it's his last
the
show.
The Middle East?
Yeah. It's just with a lot of quotes. Middle East.
He's out $10 million. He's going to get paid $10 million for a show.
I like that you see that fucking, you know, they're in that big concert hall, and it looks like,
the
you
stage
know,
is right next to it?
It looks real good when it's that aerial view, but then you get to, like, this office, and it's just, like, this condemned building. Is this the same place?
You're trying to get $10 million for doing a show in the Middle East, wearing body armor and fatigue. You're ready to go. But then the money was stolen by a gangster.
God. It's Kamal. Or is how, like, everybody in this game, because nobody really says Kamal in this game, they always shout it, so it's always like, Kamal! It's like...
So, okay, so he's got something special to give you instead of $10 million. Something that's gonna put 50 down and make him feel good about it, right? Because he's about ready to pop one in this guy. What is it? What could it be? Uh-oh.
My God.
It's amazing. It's like something a 12-year-old would make.
You know, it kind of is. So, I don't know if you knew this, but you can get Crystal Skull whiskey.
Is it inspired from the game?
No, it's not inspired by the game. It's just inspired by the whole crystal skull thing. It's like, oh, there's like 8 perfectly carved crystal skulls that are ancient throughout the world and all this shit.
Wait, no. This game came up with this, okay? Don't tell me this history shit.
I'm just bringing it up because there's a really amazing video for it where Dan Aykroyd advertises it, because he's way into, like, conspiracy shit.
He's way into crystal skulls?
He's way into crystal skulls,
He should be friends with 50 Cent.
Well, if you put in a secret code, you might unlock somebody who sounds a little like Dan Aykroyd.
What?
There's no Dan Aykroyd in this game.
Don't get me excited like that. Jesus Christ.
No, there's... There are some cheats in the game, though. There's some really good shit. Just like possibly exploding bullet cheats.
I also like how the fact that 50 is just like, human organs are for sale, and he's just like, another day at the office. What? Yeah. Sell human organs, no big deal. Oh no, it's an ambush. They're trying to grab his skull. 50, save your skull! Save it!
I kind of wish there was also a mode with, like, deflated Fitty head. So it's like, you know, he's going for his skull, but it's quite literally his skull. It's just,
oh,
like,
shit,
all
they,
deflated.
Like, sniped the driver. This is insane. This is just another day at the office for Fitty. He knows what's up. Oh, I don't know. Can he handle the rocket launcher?
No, he totally can in this game, so...
How do they miss? This is the worst shot ever. Sorry, I've been playing...
Fitty Sen's got electromagnetic thing. It just repels everything. It's like Metal Gear Solid 2.
Okay.
No, but like when you play this, like on normal mode, Fitty can take 2 rockets point blank to the chest and still live.
Yeah, so?
I mean, it seems accurate to life, but I'm just glad that there's probably some point where...
Watch your skull. Watch your skull. Oh, no.
There's probably some point
Who is this?
Oh, I forget her name. It's been so long since I last played this.
Oh, did you see that move? That's amazing!
Yeah.
No! No, Fitty, your skull! Look! Watch out! Okay, it's alright.
It's fine.
Wait, no, she's grabbing it! Shoot her! Ah!
Oh, man.
So, yeah, this is the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
So we're going to actually play this game co-op.
Yeah, I've never actually been able to play this game co-op, so if you can go ahead and invite me.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Thanks, guys. We're going to hide some names here. We love you all, but we, these are not actually our accounts, mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that people don't, you know, harass the wrong people. I mean, I love being harassed by you guys, but these people might not like it. So, good, swap it over. You've been invited.
Yep.
And we can also switch it back to the gameplay, at least first gameplay, so.
Yeah.
So I'm here at the beginning. It looks like my, I don't even see my Humvee here anymore. Like, it's gone.
Mm-hmm.
It's like not even here. That's bullshit. And
I'll be in real quick.
You're gonna be in really quick. Okay. All right. So we gotta watch this cool boost animation. So I hit A here. Oh, I have to hold it.
Yep.
Yeah. That trick went up there.
God damn it.
I can't believe that the ASRB would force them to censor that.
Yeah.
So okay, what's happening here? All right. Lay him out, Fitty!
So,
okay.
They teach you all about, you know, just being able to punch a dude a whole bunch, but...
Don't you just, like, mash B the whole time? Like, I try to do it all skillfully.
So, there actually is timing to this, where if you don't press punch until they're about to, like, punch you square in the jaw, you'll teleport them to an alternate dimension where Fitty Scent beats the shit out of them while there's, like, grunge filters overlaid on top of everything.
I love grunge filters.
Yeah.
That's like game development right there. All right, so we're supposed to go down here.
Mm-hmm.
Can you not animate over me while it's happening?
Nah.
Okay.
All right, so I am. Oh wait, stop! Come back here. Take a look at this.
What are we doing?
Look at this fucking sweet collectible.
What?
Just pick up posters of yourself for points and money.
So there is a level up system to this too, right? So we want to like collect everything.
You can just buy upgrades.
Okay.
You can buy better guns, and you can buy some other goofy-ass shit.
Alright, do we want to switch to split-screen mode?
In a little bit.
Okay. So there's a danger over there. Am I shooting that? Sorry, it's hard to do this because we can't hear the games in here. We have to play them quietly so that you guys can hear at home what we're doing.
We'll be fixing that soon.
Yep, we're gonna be fixing that soon.
But yeah, this has...
He's red. I can shoot him.
There is one thing this game...
Whoa, what was that?
Hold on, Tony Yayo will take care of it. Tony Yayo always takes care of it.
Oh, that was nice. Thanks, Tony Yayo.
So this game, it has no, like, it only has co-op. There's no other multiplayer that's, like, you know, versus mode or anything. But they made this game, like, replayable by making it, like, score-based. So, like, every time you're doing everything, you're, like, racking up a combo multiplier, and then there's this fucking sweet thing you can do where if I just click in the left stick, we swear.
Oh, all right, so hold on. I'm going to swear at you right now. Come on, get some. You going down, son. This is what I'm. And I like the fact that our mouths don't move at all. Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, the G unit, they're telepathically linked.
Alright, go ahead. You gotta, yeah.
But the swear button isn't just like a haha, you can swear. It actually is like a gameplay mechanic.
It's a core gameplay mechanic. So the most optimal way to swear is before or after you kill somebody.
After. Because so every time you swear, it just adds a 10% bonus to whatever thing you just did. And then we have these little time challenge things. I think this game had some like nice little ideas. Some of this stuff. Like, I like these time challenge things. Like, if you complete them, you get, like, a whole bunch of really good shit.
Oh, chivos.
Yeah.
Alright, so here's another one of these great cutscenes. Oh, this guy's gonna get laid out. Wait! He double-crossed you! Come on!
Oh, he, like, quadruple-crosses you. I don't trust this man. It's like fucking Revolver Ocelot. Except his ambitions are much smaller. He just wants the fucking skull.
Okay.
That bitch has got my skull, and I want it back. I need weapons.
It's okay.
It's real good.
It's okay. You can... It's all about the delivery, man. What do you mean, if you have the money? You don't have the money. You owe him $10 million.
That's my favorite shot in the whole game, where he's like, if you need the money, and Fitty's like... He just looks like he doesn't know what the concept of money is. You need money, and Faye's like, the fuck is that?
Yeah, but he's really about getting it, though. He was owed $10 million for that concert.
Mm-hmm.
Testing Mr. 50, can you hear testing me? Mr. Fitty.
Wait, stop. I need to collect a poster of my best friend 50 Cent. I did it.
Okay. Oh, this guy's there. I need to swear after I kill them. So Tony Yayo's, one of his swears is that he's going to end your whole generation.
Yeah, he threatens to not end you, but your entire fucking generation. I haven't actually heard all of these because, like, every member in the G-Unit has their own swears. They're not, like...
I thought you played this game, like, a million times.
I have, but I've never been able to play it co-op, actually. It's always been single player.
So you're always Fitty?
Yeah, I was always Fitty.
You can't pick and play as somebody else?
No, you can't.
Oh, my bar is on fire. Does that mean I've been swearing at the right
time? If you press Y, you use gangsta fire, which is just, like, bullet time, essentially.
Okay, and when do you need that? Anytime you want to be a gangster?
Anytime you want to do that.
All right, hold on. I'm gonna gangster kill this guy right up here.
Whoa.
Boo. Can you swear in gangster time too?
You can. You almost went to the Fitty zone.
Hold on, I'm in the Fitty zone right here.
Nah, that's just normal. That's normal, just murdering a man.
Oh, I fucked it up.
Oh well.
I fucked it up. I'm sorry. I'm not quite to the level.
But yeah, it's
of 50 Cent yet.
The Fitty Zone doesn't really do anything extra. It just looks different. I think it might get you slightly more score, maybe. Also, I'll have you know that the leaderboards for this game, for a very long time,
are still up.
I don't know if they're still up now. They probably are. I mean, if this works, the multiplayer's or the leaderboard's probably still up. One of the top players, like, for score on this game for the longest time was fucking Tony Yayo.
like his name was Tony Yayo, or
no,
was
I mean,
Tony Yayo?
It was
like he
literally Tony
himself.
Yayo
played himself.
Yeah, like he literally
that
played.
That means he played like empty co-op sessions, just so that he could play as himself because they don't let you. Play
well, no, I don't mean. I don't mean he did. He played himself.
He did.
I mean,
no, he played as himself. I want to believe it. Okay.
He had like he was like the best dude at this in this game for a long time.
Oh, dude, forced walk sequences.
It's cinematic.
This is what makes me happy about video games. It's a forced walk sequence.
Then you get to a part where Tony Yayo's like...
Oh, can we not both go through at the same time?
Tony Yayo's like, look at all that juice! And then you're like, god damn it.
As he plays... But 50's not there because he's playing as himself. So he has to join a co-op session, but no one's... I just want to believe that there's nobody there to like to play with him. Like,
you just
want to
imagine
like, okay.
That the G-Unit was very lonely playing the video game they started.
Oh, targets. You get money for shooting those.
Yeah, they're collectibles. There's like five.
I wanted to
level.
Shoot it, and it was good game design, right?
Uh-huh.
I can't get through. Oh, there I go.
Yep. Boom. I enjoy hitting, mashing the swear button as much as you possibly can when you're lifting up the doors, because then it seems like they just really piss off at this garage door.
I did not know you could do that. Oh, there's a lot of stuff that you can do in this game that I'm not aware of. Like, when I was still working for old THQ, they would allow us to get the games for, like, you know, at cost. And so, like, I bought two copies of this game because I was like, oh, it's co-op, we can play with my friends. And then, like, I think we played once, and then they just kind of, like, quit.
Oh.
And I don't know why.
Dang.
This is about as far as we made it, though, is up to here. So I never got to learn all the cool stuff.
I just stabbed a dude in his gut.
Hold on, I wanna stab this dude. I get to do stabbing, too. I'm 50. Why don't I have a knife?
It's the kills you get are based on what side you approach them from, if I remember correctly.
All right, so where do I need to knife him?
I think
that was some G
you,
shit right there.
I think you approach them. It was. It really. All right. Was.
Let's. Should we go split screen?
So
they can see. They can see who's doing better. Action right here. Look at this technology right here. Boom shakalaka. All right. I'm gonna go in the 50 zone. Why am I not in the 50 zone?
It's the timing for it is real tight.
There we go. There, knifed right in the chest. That made me feel way better. about everything in life, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Are we
oh
going?
Shit! This is where Tony Yayo goes. Whoa! Check out this view, or something like that.
Oh really?
Yeah, he has a really funny line. It's just like, look at this vista we made. Oh, he already said it, but yeah, Yayo's just like, whoa! These
Wait a
graphics.
Second. We only got bronze new unlockables.
Yeah, I mean, it's mostly like concept art, but there are like a couple cheat codes.
No, there's do like, not make concept art an unlockable.
I feel like concept art is like the lowest tier you can have for unlockables.
Like concept art just happens when you're online, okay?
Yeah. But there are a couple good unlockables.
Single screen.
Oh yeah. There are a couple good unlockables.
Right,
mainly
who's this guy. This guy seems legit. He's wearing a
leather
jacket.
Oh, he's a dude. He's like the merchant from Resident Evil 4. He sells you stuff. Yeah.
Okay, so they're teaching you how to unlock stuff, but he's in character. He's like, I have all this stuff. Click through this menu.
Yeah.
Spend all the points you get from swearing at people at me.
Mm-hmm.
That swear currency. It's like the swear jar, but it's like you get to use it for good stuff.
Yeah, Fitty just finally decided that like putting money in a jar that isn't yours anymore because he swore was fucking bullshit and he might as well just keep it. But also, Fitty encounters paranormal shit all the time, so it's a magic jar where you put in money and even more pump money appears.
I'm actually surprised, like, this is totally synced between the two. Like, mm-hmm. We're seeing the exact same cutscene at the exact same time.
Yeah.
So I think somebody in chat was mentioning that, oops, I'm getting cool stuff here. Bring it on, motherfuckers! That's what they said, that's what they were saying in chat. They were just basically saying all the top tier swears.
Yeah.
50 zone. Boom. Boom. Boom.
Now
in the chest.
It ain't exactly the 50 zone. There's no grunge filters.
Wait. Okay. We have to do one of those.
You got real close one time.
I got really close, but I got too excited. I was pushing the buttons too fast.
Mm-hmm.
You can find him in the club. I wonder what the club is like here in the Middle East.
It's just like a normal North American club, if I remember correctly. Oh, actually, no, wait. You need to stay in place. Here, I'm actually going to switch back to just your camera for this. Stay completely still, but just hold right in the analog stick. Just keep holding it.
Which analog stick?
The right stick, just so that you're constantly turning in place. Check out his hips.
It's over, motherfucker. Fuck you.
Yeah.
Pussies. You're going down, son.
Okay. All right. We're playing a game here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But I just love that animation of his hips just going woo woo woo.
Come on, get it, bitch. You want some of this, huh?
I feel like if you swear all the time, it should be kind of like Smash Brothers, where there's like a swear list, and like as you use it more, it gets less effective, because you can't just swear all the time. Where are we going? Okay, we're going up there. Okay.
Yep.
Oops, sorry. I can't help it. I keep slipping up. All right.
Gotta put the C4 there, man.
All right, what happens if I just stand on it?
I don't know. Let's find out.
A plus. Oh, there's guys. They're actually hurting me. Okay, hold on. I know you can't actually die with this game. I think we played it on extra hard.
Yeah, you can die, but like normal mode, this is just normal mode for the most part is just like a really chill thing.
Yeah, but this is just a fun game,
yeah,
right? Like,
it's not a game that really needs too much challenge. It's just like, haha, I'm 50 Cent.
Gangster mode. Oh, wait, you're going into yayo mode? What the hell? Oh, wait, it's because I hit the button.
Yeah.
It slowed it down for all of us. How come you get a mode and 50 doesn't?
Oh, bitch.
Sorry, I keep clicking the swear button, like, whatever it feels like. Oh, I haven't touched it in 3 seconds.
Yeah, whenever I see somebody plant a bomb, the first thing I always think is, wow, that guy's a punk bitch for planting that bomb.
Oh, 30 seconds. Wait, that doesn't slow down the timer when you go into gangster mode.
Nope.
Fine, get out of the courtyard. I'll guide you from there.
All right, I got 2x kill.
Anwar,
what are you doing? All right, who are these guys? So,
dudes.
I've got 9,490-something.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, how many more people do I need to kill to get 10 million 50 bucks?
It's the entire country, essentially.
Okay, that's
and
all
you,
there is.
You really do just about fuck up the entire country throughout this game.
I can't roll past you. You're gonna be the death of me. I was gonna punch him! I was gonna knife him! Why do you have to take that away from me?
Tony Yayo is well known for being a kill stealer.
Jesus.
What
right.
The fuck, and why you nearly got us killed in that shithole?
What? No. Are you off?
You better, Emma. When I find you, you can owe me
back. Oh, you can't swear during these force walk sequences.
Nah, that'd be great. Oh, wait, Yayo isn't talking, though.
Market Square. Head north and you should
stop. Nah, I can't swear either.
Okay, let's go.
But we can swear a whole bunch after it's done. I mean, that's exactly what I do after I get off the phone every single time.
Yeah. Just can't keep the rage inside. You gotta let it all out.
Oh, man.
It's a new form of anger management.
Nope. Snuck out in front of you.
Check out all this shit.
Check out all this shine. That's another great line from this game. Unfortunately, I don't think in the time we have allotted we'll be able to get to my absolute favorite part. Well, the second favorite part in which Tony Yayo makes a fucking OSHA joke. Because I feel like the G units were really concerned with OSHA practice.
They are.
Dude,
there was an OSHA joke made just on Twitter.
What?
Just for the picture. Yeah, someone made an OSHA joke on Twitter.
Huh.
Shop. All right.
Well, purchase. No, I mean the actual literal G.
All right, so we should go full screen on mine. So I'm purchasing weapons. Does it purchase weapons for all of us, or?
I believe it's separate.
It's separate, so.
Because we have separate amounts of money.
That, it's $6,000 for an MP.
Yeah.
These are some really weak weapons in Counter-Strike, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
I think
I've planted the bomb at least once. I should have enough for an AK.
I think you need to take a look at the swears.
All right, hold on. What else? Purchase
and taunts.
Taunts. All right, that's all
now
we're
check
do.
This out. Profanity, bragging, and triple X.
Okay.
Those are your stats for your taunts. Every upgrade just brings all of them up at the same time. So they don't actually matter. It's just fucking hilarious.
Hold on. I can spend 50,000. Is 50,000 to learn how to swear better?
It's
there are
12-year-olds
that get it for cheaper by just watching YouTube. All right, 20,000? 20,000?
You can't even get the next set of swears, man.
Dia Condictor. Is that what it says? You already own. Dicta Malficuf. Ridicule your enemy with a whole new selection of insults. Yeah, that's exactly what I want to do, but I can't because I don't have $1,000,000. All right,
mm-hmm.
Counter kills. Ooh, some knifing.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the ones that I have. Oh, it's only 2,000 for serial killer? That's me right there. All right, cool. Purchase yes. weapons?
It's weird how the counter kills work. You have to like put them in a playlist, so it's like if you get a whole bunch in a row, it'll be like go down the playlist as like the
weapon?
Next
one. Do you
want
to equip this weapon? Hell yeah, I want to equip this weapon. All right, so you have to go do that, and it pauses the whole game.
Yeah, it's a little weird that you have to do it separately, but...
Yeah. You don't get to buy weapons. Look at you, you already probably know, like, all the amazing ones right here. Look, he's just going through and he's clicking and buying. Can you see this? How do I switch it to what you're doing? I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm good. Listen to this guy. I don't play this game that much. I'm good, I got all the weapons. I was in there for like 2 minutes. Okay, hold on. Oh, I'm not gonna shotgun them from here, but I can pistol them from here.
Yeah.
Look at that. Look at that sneak kill right there.
Oh, there's a target
swear.
Here. Right up there.
Boop. I don't know why I bought a pistol.
It's because you can eventually dual wield pistols and it looks really cool.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You can kind of juggle ragdolls with it like you're in fucking Devil May Cry.
Or Saints Row 3.
Uh-huh.
You know, this game came out after
this was 2009.
So it came out before Saints Row 3.
I remember it was 2009 because I said that this game came out during the year of the helicopter, where like every single third-person shooter had a helicopter boss fight.
Dude, the whole trailer had that amazing helicopter fight.
Yeah,
remember?
The trailer is really good.
He kills the guy in it, and he runs in, and he holds the pilot at gunfire, and then he's one hand on like
yeah,
the 50 cal.
It's
the
an
other
awesome
hand,
trailer.
Yeah.
Oh, another sign.
And then after he's done. Where are we going? I don't know. And then after he's done, he's like, see you, motherfucker, it's done, boom! And caps him and then, like, jumps out of the helicopter.
It's a really good trailer, yeah. For everybody here, if you haven't seen, like, the...
There's two of them. There's one where they talk. That one's dumb. But the one where they're just, like, shooting up stuff, like, yeah. In the middle of the Middle East.
Yeah.
That's the good one.
Mm-hmm.
I think there was a couple clips of it from the beginning. Are we being shot
There's
at?
There's a man shooting me, but yeah, it doesn't matter, because I am invincible.
Where did he go? He disappeared.
We telefragged him.
Okay, fine. Ooh, telefrag. That's some old school talk right there.
Uh-huh. None of the children are gonna know what telefragging is.
Oh, they will.
So, you know what? I just encountered a few days ago. I was doing a different stream from my place. I was on a friend's stream. And they were playing a game where a door opened, and the sound effect for the door opening was the fucking your friend just sign on an AOL Instant Messenger sound.
Why?
I don't know. It was just
a
sound effect they used.
Was it like a really bad game that you're like?
It was like a really obscure, like game somebody made on the internet. But okay. It used the AOL Instant Messenger your friend just signed on door opening noise, and I died laughing. And there were a whole bunch of people watching the stream who were just a couple years younger, and I was like, why is that funny? I just fucking felt like 80 years old. Don't even know what AOL Instant Messenger sounds like.
Welcome to game development. I feel like I'm 80 years fucking old. Alright.
Like, am I gonna play the You Got Mail sound clip? And they'll go like, what was that?
They'll play the movie from 1998.
They type in You Got Mail. It's like, why? Is that from a movie? I don't get... Are you a big fan of Tom Hanks?
I bet if you were to watch that movie now...
Uh-huh.
Like, the way that they depicted the internet, it's gonna feel so foreign. You're gonna be like, oh, this is like one of those movie magic things where they, like,
it'll
up some shit. But
it'll
like,
be like how the, when news sites were, or news sites, fuck, television news was, like, reporting on the internet, and they would call it internet. Not the internet, but internet with a capital I, like it was a person.
I want to go into 50 zone. Why can't I enter the 50 zone?
Gotta get better at timing those counter kills.
Also, I'm getting tired of killing a guy with a knife in the chest.
It's probably because it's the very first counter kill in your playlist. It's weird how they set that stuff up.
Okay. You have to get to the C4 on the tank. Can I?
I'm doing it. Look out, it's gonna blow.
I'm gonna stand it. Let's just both stand on it, because I bet it's fine. 50, he's bulletproof, right?
No, we actually died from that.
Oh, fuck!
Yeah. I do enjoy that the game over screen is 50 Cent's blood cells.
It's his blood cells. They're coming back to life. Load the last checkpoint. Sure. You left
the game.
Oh,
shit.
Why did you leave the game?
I don't know why I left the game.
Can you join the game again?
Yeah, I'll try real quick.
All right. Chip. How can I do this with AI? Whoa, look at these textures streaming in. Boo! Oh, there they go. Pop. Alright, I guess I'll go a different way.
Yeah,
you saw this.
You'll have to re-invite me, unfortunately.
All right.
I can't join you.
Alright, hold on a second. I gotta kill these fools here. Mm-hmm. You're saying this game's easy. This game's easy.
It's not bad.
So, okay, anyway. Tricked out Trey.
People in the chat are right. 50 Cent literally got his blood all over the sand.
Aww. I'll let it slide. Okay. I think I was being shot at the whole time.
You're fine.
That was like me picking up the cell phone and being like, hey, come on over. What are you doing? Not much, man. I'm just in the middle of a gunfight. I'm 50 Cent. Mm-hmm. Only, like, he probably sounded a lot cooler than that. Just saying. He probably swore a couple times in the middle. It's like, hey, I'm 50 Cent. Yeah, it's cool. Just, motherfucker, get the fuck! Yeah, I'm just, you wanna come over? It's cool. Just killing some guys in the Middle East. Motherfucker, get the fuck up! Yeah.
So, cool. Really bizarre thing is happening here
minutes.
On my end. There we go. Okay, Tony Yayo is alive again.
Alright. I just need to set the... Billy can't run. Why?
He's been watching a lot of Star Trek. He can only do the Captain Kirk action role anywhere.
I know. It's like... Could they just not get the roadie run to work? Alright. I gotta get out because... Apparently C4 on tanks is...
C4
dangerous.
On tanks... Maybe it was the explosion from the tank. The tank blowing up and not the C4. Because we appear to be impervious to C4 generally.
Well, should I try it every time? I don't know. I feel like I should try it every time.
It's a little dangerous.
Oh, look, there's a poster of somebody up here. Who is it?
It might be one of the generic terrorist posters.
Punch. Why would I want to collect terrorist posters?
I know, I would only ever want to
He kind of looks like he's from Cobra.
I was going to say Counter-Strike.
No, not Counter-Strike. Come on. You've played Counter-Strike at least once.
I have.
I have it on record.
Maybe
that you
up
did
to
it.
Three times.
What do you mean three times? Are you playing without me? Are you doing something that I don't know?
No,
about?
I mean lifetime.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And two of them were here at the office.
Whoa! Did you see that ragdoll?
No. Oh. Sorry. You gotta switch it to split screen so that people can see what.
Well,
the hell's
there's actually a cutscene coming up real
there's
soon.
There's a cutscene coming up. I know where all the cutscenes are. Why don't you go ahead and just, like, warp me ahead, too? Show me where all, like, the zips are in the level, too.
I mean,
so if you just wiggle around here and jump up here, you can fall through. Saves you about 13 seconds.
There's a zip here. You can go through about a quarter of the level. It's pretty fast.
Why do we keep getting the bronze sense?
It's because we're not gangster enough to get the gold medal. All
right. Do you need to switch it back to full screen?
No, we're good.
Okay. I'm supposed to die tonight. Chivo's unlocked. So he's in a strip club.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. So this is 50 Cent in his natural habitat. Wait, is that one of the other members of the Gene Unit?
No. This is a character they made up for this.
They
so,
made up characters.
Unfortunately, I don't...
These
yeah.
guys all exist in real life somewhere, okay? They're just
Maybe.
In hiding.
Yeah.
It's a pretty rough place out there.
Yeah, they're in one of 50's...
They're in the streets, okay?
They're
you're
in one
up
of
here in your ivory tower,
bunkers.
Not know what's going on. They're in the streets.
Uh-huh.
So don't disrespect
Getting
them by saying...
Uh-huh. Just another day at the office, Fiddy said for the fifth fucking time today.
I wonder how he wrote it. He wrote the game. He had to.
I don't know.
I bet so, in his contract, he's like, I write all my own dialogue.
There are three 50 Cent games. There was one for the PS2, there's this one, and there was one on the PSP, which was real, probably the strangest one gameplay-wise, in that it was like a top-down like Diablo thing, where you would like kick corpses and money would shoot out of them. Yeah, it was like an isometric like Diablo-esque thing. It was weird. But there, the very first one was 50 Cent Bulletproof, which is a lot harder to play than this one is.
You know quite a bit about these 50 Cent games.
I did a lot
games.
Of research when I played
I
this game
I did a lot
before.
Of research. I played a lot of these games for how many hours? How many hours do you have in this game alone? No
one can touch it. Probably like 20-ish. The game, 20, the game's like five 20. Hours to go through.
All right, so I'm multiplied by five, so you have 100 hours in the game. It's okay. You don't have to be shy about it.
Uh-huh.
Also,
100 hours.
Also, the Mantis SNV is saying this isn't a game. It's a live documentary. It's happening right this instant. Mm-hmm. That means that he does this just for fun every time someone boots up this game.
I mean, when
it
you're
is directly live streamed from
when you're so
the
rich.
Middle East, so that we can.
When you're so rich, I mean, you don't have much else to do. Oh, yes! This is the fucking... This doesn't need to be split screen because we have the same view, but...
This is hitting the biggest ramp! Yes! This is my favorite part.
This is... I want to thank... I don't know who did it, but I want to thank whoever put Rolling Start at the start of this mission.
Because wait, who's driving?
I'm driving.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Is this Saints Row? Can I drive like an asshole? Did these things break? Yes, destruction?
Yeah, there's some destructibles.
All right, let's see what happens if I drive over this way. So, wait a second, what happened in this story? I was too caught up in watching the chat.
We have to find out where the bad guy's base is, and we're following their, like...
Is it impossible for me to, like, get the car stuck?
You can get the car stuck, but it's hard. You can make it like bump around.
There's like bumper cars in here.
Yeah.
Ram the obstruction 25.
Right there. Get that fence. Get that fence.
What's this fence? I can't tell. It's not real.
It's glowing red.
Okay. Where's the big ass ramp?
Where the fuck are they?
This is how I talk to my friends.
Uh-huh.
I'm trying to hit these people running away. Are they innocents or are they just
no,
people
they're,
to kill?
They're bad guys.
They count money. They count money for kills.
Yeah.
Yes. Destructible. It's different color than everything. He's not screaming, Kamal. All right, here we go. These guys are red. I can kill them.
Yep.
Okay, there we go. Boom.
Whoa.
Killing spree. Can I swear? Massacre. Dude, you got an achievement for it.
Yeah. You want some of this, huh? Yeah, just keep pushing that thing.
I'll just hit every wall.
So the,
you really can.
If you have gangsta fire for this, instead of bullet time, you get to...
Hit that biggest ramp!
We got the big-ass ramp.
You get a Chivo for it too, ramping up!
Uh-huh.
I hit gangster time right as I hit it, so it would be extra epic.
Yeah.
Wait, they can fire missiles from up there? Shoot them down! What are you doing?
I'm shooting them.
Yeah, yo, come on! Tell me that they can't hit you. Don't tell me
they,
that.
It's more of a thing to look cool. They can't
no,
really ever hit
don't,
you.
No, don't make this game seem less gangster than it really is.
There's a convoy on the other side of the barrier!
There's a convoy on the other side of the barrier. Can I jump over there?
Nah.
There's like some major catch-up too. All those.
Yeah.
All right, let's see if I can go over there. Oh,
there
cool.
We go.
Oh, I should probably avoid
some
the guys
with some
of
these trucks
the...
have explosive barrels on them for some... Why not?
Kamikaze, come on.
Yeah.
Is that my car on the bottom right taking damage?
No, that's the convoy we're following up
ahead.
Are
you sure? My car is, like, smoky and...
It is smoky, but you're at full health.
I'm just trying to tip it, see if I can tip the car upside down.
My other favorite thing in this mission is the you fall, like this is a life or death thing, but like you fall down that big, you know, that big dip, and then Fiddy and Ye are just like, yeah, all right! Like, their voice clips is like...
Oh, there's another ramp.
Yeah, there you go. Make sure to wiggle the tires. Yeah.
I messed it up because there was a barrel in the way. I'm sorry, stream. I'll do better next time. There's another... Ram the obstruction. You can just shoot it?
Yeah.
That's no fun. It told me to ram it, and you had to shoot it. Why you gotta take that away from me?
Again, Yayo likes to steal kills.
Yeah, Yayo is a big kill stealer.
And fun stealer.
Fun stealer? What?
Oh. Want to hit that barricade? Too late. I had the fun.
Yeah, but you can't shoot the ramp, and then it counts as me jumping off the ramp, right?
Yeah. Does
it? I can't have all the fun.
Nah.
No, you got it, 50. And what? We're back with the convoy.
I'm trying to swear, but I can't. It's too hard.
You're almost at the checkpoint.
Can't swear and drive, man. That's way too dangerous. That's not gangsta. That's being dangerous.
I keep unlocking the shit tier. What are we missing on this? Do we need to do a new game plus so we have, like, awesome weapons and stuff?
That actually does help, but it's just from replaying the stuff.
20 hours, new game plus. I know everything about new game plus, and I've only played for 20 hours.
It's a short game.
It's 100 hours.
It's a short game.
It's a 10-hour game, dude. I remember when we were advertising this. It's a 10-hour game.
Well,
is that short? Is the 10-hour game short?
No, 10 hours fine.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. 10 hours, like, an average length of a game. A pretty normal length. Let's see. Oh, there goes the texture.
Yep. Gotta stream it in.
Should have hard. Can I jump up this ladder? No. Machine gun, what the fuck is up, Fitty? I'm gonna die. I don't want my blood all over the sand. I need to take cover. There we go.
It's over for you.
Alright, I'm ready.
This is the part of the game where I discovered that...
That I played it for over 60 hours.
No, this is the part where I first discovered that Fitty can take two rockets to the chest and be A-OK.
You just keep walking in front of... There's no friendly fire in this game at all.
Nope.
This is incredible. Killing spree. Oh, I just need to swear to keep my spree up.
Oh my god, he fucking just vaporized.
Alright, let me see if I can take one of these rockets to the chest. I don't believe you. Here we go, number two. Holy shit, it doesn't like do no damage to you!
Two rockets, yeah! Two rockets, Fitty don't give a fuck.
You know, how many times 50 Cent has been shot? Please don't tell me you know this.
What was it, like 9 times or something?
Oh my god, you probably do! I bet that's right!
Yeah, he got shot like 9 times.
Yeah, I bet he
Well,
did.
He was shot at 9 times. I think only 2 bullets actually hit him.
No, I remember him being like shot. That's like why he's got that draw, because he's shot in the jaw.
Yeah, he was shot in the jaw, for sure.
Yeah.
But I think, like, out of the 9 bullets that were shot at him, like, only 2 actually hit him.
Oh, hold on, there's a guy up here. I could shoot him, or I could shoot the explosive red barrel.
Always shoot the barrel. Oh, these barrels are weird in that they take a couple shots before they actually blow up.
Well, if they blew up right away, you'd probably be upset. Game design, man. This game feels like it would be better with grenades.
I have grenades. Yeah, it's one of the bumpers.
Alright,
I just Molotov cocktails and there's like normal grenades, I think.
I can throw a grenade. These guys don't even know that they're walking into it. Like, watch this guy right here. He's like, I'm gonna come over. There's not gonna be a grenade there. What? How are you impervious to grenades?
He's on the other side of the fence. I think that was just enough to dodge it.
Danger. That's what I want to do. My middle name is Danger. It was legally changed. Last month.
Uh-huh.
Just so that I could make that comment on stream.
Wow, you're real devoted, dude.
Hey man, it's the Volition way. It's all or nothing.
Can we expense name changes?
You're about to be teleported. Oh, hey, what's up? Force walk. Oh, think you're awesome, huh? Yeah, look at that. Gonna stutter step all over you. Alright. Wait, something tells me there's a collectible in here.
There doesn't look like it, actually. Oh, you've got exploding bullets right now.
Why?
So those time challenges that come up, if you do good, they give you different rewards, and one of them is all your bullets blow up.
I'm swearing right now. I'm trying to swear.
Yeah, yeah.
Kamal could be waiting. I bet Kamal's the end boss at the very end of the game. They're just like, no. Kamal could be here. He could be here any second. He could be here. And he's he's never there.
I think...
Or he is there, but then he just gets away.
I think the final boss is, like, the boss of Kamal or something like that. I can't remember. Jesus, you lucky monster. Oh, no. Tony Yayo, you're in danger.
Hold on. Where are you? Where are you?
Coming to it's okay. You.
Hold on, I got him. I got him. I got him. I got him. Hold on.
He
seems to be impervious to bullets right now.
Well, it's what happens when you take telepathic hold of them. I've claimed this man is mine, so you can't hurt him. I extended my shields over him, my gangster shields.
Come on. Come on. Why do I keep doing the same kill over and over again? I bought a new kill.
My new goal is anytime you're doing one of those kills is somehow photobomb it in the background. I did it just now, so.
CCL is asking, the real question is, will Alex enter the Fitty Zone by the end of the stream? I don't know. I feel like it's not going to happen. I need a little bit of encouragement to enter the Fitty Zone.
Try hard enough, anything can happen, man.
All right, hold on. Fitty Zone? Fitty Zone? Fitty Zone?
Nope,
It's a knife kill. I mean, it seemed like it was better. It's from a different angle.
Ah, I almost got it.
How do you enter the Fitty Zone? Do you
so
have to
the
block
Fitty
it?
Zone, Fitty Zone is, you don't block it, you, oh shit, I'm dying. Can you help? I just got shotgun right in the chest.
Hey, yeah. Yeah, what now?
Oh
what
no! Don't fall above me!
Savior. I should have threw a grenade on you. Sealed the deal.
Oh,
it's like, that's how the G unit rolls.
You should have pulled out your gun with a chainsaw on it and cut me in half.
Oh, man. Why is this game so much fun? This game should not be this fun.
It's pretty fun.
It's really fun.
I mean, it's real standard stuff, but it's all done...
It's done in a really fun way.
Well, the one thing I think is kind of unique is all the scoring shit. You don't see that too often. Also, my favorite arcade machine's over here, Ninja Mystery.
Hey, what's up, Ninja Mystery? Oh, it's impervious to bullets, too.
Yeah.
All right, this machine gun's pretty good.
Oh, actually, you should get right over here. I'm going to be up against the wall. Just shoot me a shitload. Yeah!
It's okay. That's what I thought.
Fuck you, piece of shit!
Need to paint some walls real quick. Yayo's there to help you out. Just shoot him a lot.
I feel like these crates exist only just to remind you that you can still punch people.
Yeah, maybe.
Look, a payphone. We should call somebody. Like, it's 2009. Okay, so this game was supposed to come out in, like, 2007, wasn't it? And
maybe
then it
eight?
Had, like, a really troubled development.
I don't know if it had troubled development.
I seem to remember when it was coming over to THQ.
Yeah.
They were 3 months away from finishing the game.
Hmm.
And, like, it had been that way for almost a year.
Okay.
And so when we got it, we, like, started just advertising it a whole bunch.
Yeah.
Is this going to be a zone that you can get through with me?
Yeah. It's just like a way to go around these dudes.
Oh, some slowdown. Uh-oh. We gotta kill these four assault enemies. We're gonna run out of time. Come on. Come on, you can do this. Alright. We got the bonus for killing these guys.
Yep.
They were just mall security anyway.
Paul Blart, mall cop.
Oh god.
Paul Blart Mall Cop 2! Great movies, you guys.
Alright, are we in the right zone?
Hold on, there's still one dude.
Wait, 3 seconds, get him! No, the bonus! Why did you let the bonus go? Failed the bonus. How could you fail the bonus?
I failed you, Fitty.
Alright, we need to paint some more walls here.
Okay. Oh, wait. Yeah, let's paint this wall. It's looking pretty bad right now.
All
right. Need some more color in it. Thanks, Fitty. I needed that.
I wonder how long those decals lay around for. Yeah, Kamal. Don't be a bitch. Come back.
You're just like shouting over each other all the fucking time.
Squiddy scent ink on the sand has been said already, right?
It has.
Well, I just said it again, so there you go.
Yeah.
Look at him right there. His goons aren't friendly fire. How did we get that mode?
You know he's evil because he kills his own henchmen.
I'm trying to kill you, but it's not working. I'm trying to be
best friends.
Oh.
It doesn't work.
She's got the skull, though. There's a fucking army here. Where the hell is he getting his men? He's got an army. I need someone to cut off that flow. What else can get busted? Fucking figure it out.
Whatever you want. Are you sure? Just dialogue.
It's real good. The previous, the 50 Cent game that's on the PS2, it was written by one of the dudes who wrote for the fucking Sopranos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think that they just write his songs? Like they're like ghostwriting his songs?
Maybe.
Oh, I'm gonna throw a grenade on him. Do my own grenades hurt?
They hurt your view at least. I don't know if it hurts me.
Is there a crouch? There's no crouch, there's just swearing. You know, it's a lot better than teabagging anyway. There's no grass in this game anywhere.
Teabagging on the sand is way less sexual, so... This game's in the clear.
Wait, kill three close-range enemies. Do you just have to kill them?
Guess the dude's highlighted in red.
Here they come. Kill them. Where is the last guy?
I got him. Jump on this!
My taunt just went up 25% after I killed somebody. Or was it a taunt bonus?
It's a bonus.
The death screams in this sound like really horrific too. It's just like, ah!
So there's, neither of us have Molotov cocktails right now, but they have like a special effect for when you burn people to death.
Yeah, burn voices. It's like...
No, not just voices. Like, there's a graphical effect where you see their bodies, like, the skin slough off and shit, and they become like fucking charred corpses. It's fucked up!
Whoa!
Yeah.
That's gangster.
Yeah, it's,
Alright, where am I going?
I have to see if I can use some Molotovs soon.
Alright.
There's still some dudes.
I wish Fitty could run.
Yeah.
He's like in such great shape, but he's just like...
He's pacing himself.
Yeah.
Slow and steady wins the crystal skull.
No, it's so you can do all this murdering all day. I mean, like Johnny got, Fitty said, if they got into a fight. I feel like Johnny Gat can murder at like a much higher rate than Fitty Cent can. Like Fitty Cent has to have like cutscenes and talking, and Johnny Gat just like gets bored when there's like that stuff happening. It's like the standard pace for a standard action game makes Johnny Gat a little upset. All right, do I get invulnerable when I do this? Thank God.
Yeah. Alright, well I feel if 50 Cent's power level ever increases, we're gonna have to consult the writers so that they can just one-up with Gats so that he's always more powerful.
I'm gonna die.
It'll be like the fucking playground, it's like... You just say, no, I have armor that's impervious to bullets, and they're like, that's fucking bullshit. It's like, well, sorry.
There we go.
I got way better armor, because I say so.
So we just run around, shoot him up, and then we swear after we do it. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Danger. Danger, chip cheeses. Danger. Ah. I was shooting up there. I knew he was coming. My video game senses told me he was going to go there. Fitty Zone, where are you?
Oh, no.
Do you have to punch during, like, the meter?
No, Fitty Zone happens when a dude is about to punch you, and you punch him right as it's about to hit you. It's a little tough to do. It's not super intuitive. Whenever I do it, it's more by luck than anything.
No, it's more by 100 hours of gameplay than anything.
I've never been good at the Fitty Zone.
I've never been good at this game. Not enough hours, man. Oh, I got a rocket launcher now. What do I do with it?
blow some motherfuckers up. I think that's what you usually do.
Okay. Find a new way to the collapse under bridge walkway. I didn't feel like murdering those people.
I'm not sure that's correct. 50 Zone is basically like a perfect parry in a fighting game.
Okay. It's a perfect parry. There better be like some crazy graphics when you do it too. Yeah, fuck you. Fuck you. Okay. Sorry, I was.
Oh,
this game has an effect on me.
Excuse me, there's a sign to shoot. There we go. Right over here.
Oh, I thought it said on the ground floor. Sorry, I thought it's like, yeah, tank's gonna roll it, I'm gonna blow it up.
I think the only logical thing to do now, if Fitty Cent ever had another
enters
game.
Enters the Fitty Zone.
Yeah.
50 Cent, enter the Fitty Zone.
Uh-huh. It'll be like a spiritual successor to Alan Wake. 50 Cent fighting ghosts. Because by the end of this, he's proven he's better than every man in combat, so like... Might as well fucking move on to ghosts.
No, not ghosts. Yeah, ghosts, yeah, sure. I'll buy that.
Ghosts and Bigfoot, just paranormal stuff in general.
Oh, I did that rocket kill that guy.
Also, it's
there.
Open world.
Every game's open world, man.
Yeah, that's... I mean, if he ever has another game, open world...
I mean, this game is open world, right? Did you see that city over there?
Oh, yeah.
You're driving through the city, it's open world. They just thought that we just have to go to the bad guys over here, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we need to go through here. Do we just got to get around? Oh,
no, there's dudes over here at the block first.
Swear, exposed, explosive, taunt. Yes.
Fucking die.
Fucking die. That's what I say.
There was.
I guess there's, like, some helicopters chasing us. It's, like, yeah. No big deal. Oh, that lens blew, man.
You fight so many helicopters in this game. It's the only boss it's got. It's just helicopters. I'm imagining if there's another 50 Cent game, I would want it to be...
50 Cent enter the 50 helicopter?
No, it would be, like, what was that older game on the PS2 called? True Crime? Is that it?
I never played True Crime.
There's an unlockable mode for one of them where you get to play as Snoop Dogg, and you have to arrest people who are stealing your MP3s. It's real great. It's awesome.
I thought you were about to say stealing your weed.
No, it's just like, hey, people are illegally downloading my music off the internet. I have to put a stop to this.
Okay, sorry. I thought I was in the 50 zone.
No. You'll know. Trust me.
And you're in the 50 zone.
Photobombing this shit. Hey there.
Keep finding these posters and stuff.
Random Ink? Yeah, there is a game where you play as Snoop Dogg. I can't remember which True Crime it is. There's two of them on the PS2? It might be the first one. But yeah, like after you beat it or like you put in a code or something, you can play as him and it's real stupid.
Doesn't have aim snap like Call of Duty. Have to actually aim.
Yeah, it's zero aim assist, pixel perfect. No ADS.
That's how I like my games.
It's like Vanquish.
All right, let's open up this thing up here.
Oh yeah. Well, I can't run. I can only roll everywhere.
It's okay.
Actually, there's more dudes we need to blow up.
What?
We can't open it yet.
They can come up here if they want to get blown up. Feeling kind of lazy today. Yes, yeah, slow walk on the grenade.
What the fuck is Anwar doing sending them our way?
50, I swear I didn't know. I just hired them. I'm helping.
Hey, get out of my way. Stop trolling me, Yayo. Stop trolling me.
This is what Yayo does. You
nope,
can't
stop
him.
I swear. Swear. Swear.
Alright, let's go. I ain't playing, motherfucker.
I ain't playing.
That was one of my swears. Alright. Can I upgrade a swear yet? Can I just do it anytime?
No, there are payphones, and that's where you upgrade stuff.
Okay, cool. Using antiquated technology to upgrade your swear game.
Yeah.
I just want to get to payphone. Enter the 50 zone, and then swear a whole bunch.
That man just fucking disappeared.
I'm in the 50 zone, that's why. Or the slow-mo, bullet time.
Gangsta mode.
Sorry, I don't know the proper terminology for everything. What would I do if you weren't here, Chip?
You'd be getting all the game terminology wrong. That's a no-no.
All right. What's in here? I feel like we've seen this zone already.
Yeah, it's just like the other floor, it seems.
All right, split screen it up because we're splitting up. They need to know what Yayo's doing at all times. Oh, I'm being killed right here. So this new technology that allows us to do split screen, it's powered by the swear engine used in the 50 Cent game.
Yep.
Actually,
swear engine programmed by Sweary 51.
By Swear Enix.
Swear Enix. Sweary 65. Yeah.
And you'll notice that we'll never ever be able to do this split screen again without having enough swearing power. So,
we'll have
to start a swear jar.
We have an intern behind it who's got like a little bugle that's going right into his sound card. He's going like, fuck!
He's whispering, fuck! Fuck!
Yeah, it's
fuck! Like, hey, ended the whole
hey Buster.
Time.
Everything used to be powered by people running on gerbil wheels, but we've upgraded a little.
Well, come on, man. At least they're not payphones.
Here's some trivia, but not everybody knew that everything in game development is powered by fucking hamster wheels.
Hamster wheels and swearing.
Yeah.
Because every single time Premiere crashes, it's motherfucker! Oh, gosh. Reload! Jesus! Okay, there we go. It's either that or Counter-Strike. Alright, so I can swear in this game, but yeah. I can't run. I don't know how
it takes all your extra energy to keep on doing these swears. It makes you tired, man.
Yeah, well, I guess it kind of does. Are you dead?
No, I'm fine.
Here, come on, 50 zone, come on, shoot me. Look, he was winding up for the punch. Stop trolling me!
I trolled too much and now I'm dying.
I'm gonna die too, dude! Okay, Jesus. Okay, you're up.
Okay, good.
That was close there. That was really close. Explosive bullets.
Whoa, where'd that... Okay. Glad we were split screen for that, so you can see that man just shoot through the fucking ceiling.
They're asking us how versatile are the swears. Well, probably not as versatile as what 50 can do, because apparently he has upgrades. Mm-hmm. However, I don't know if I'll actually be able to show that off, because we can't find a payphone.
There was a payphone earlier, but we still didn't have enough money.
What? I got 62,000.
It was way earlier.
40,000.
Totally,
I don't know what that 62 up there is. Why are there two numbers? That's very confusing.
The 62,000 is like your score for the level.
Oh, so I gotta get up to that to get 50 points. I need to swear a lot more.
Jesus.
Where are the bad guys? Was I supposed to be in here at the beginning of the round? I think so.
Eh.
Don't want to mess with Yayo.
Alright,
we gotta go through here.
Yep.
Or we gotta go through there? We gotta go through the double one?
Looks like there's a double one.
There's something oddly nice. Oh, there's fire up there. Fire texture. It's just rolling across the ceiling. Something oddly, like, gratifying about, like, oh, I found more money, and you kick it.
The money in this game is good. It's like when you pick up bolts and Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, but I want to swear, that's why.
They're all jangly. It's like it's fucking jangling keys in front of your face.
I don't know. When someone jangles keys in front of my face, the first thing I want to do is, like, fucking die!
Here's a phone.
All right, here we go. All right. So, I can go to the shop, purchase taunts. All right, 20,000. The 30,000 taunts. 40,000 taunts. There you go. I've been saving up my whole life to get the Lenoph more taunts to enrage your enemy. I want to purchase that one. All right, so I just went up for, like, a pretty high-tier taunt. How do I change them out now so that I use
think
those?
They're just in the rotation now when you swear.
They're in the rotation. I got to get rid of the low-tier taunts. I don't want people to know I'm a fucking swear noob.
I can't remember if they're just a rotation or if they just replace the old ones, but...
All right, let's see what happens. All right.
You want some of this, huh? Don't fuck with me. Punk, bitch. You motherfucker.
Okay. Yeah.
This shit is fucked up. First one's free, motherfucker.
Okay.
Yeah, bitch. I didn't sign up for this shit.
I think he just rolls through them in one order.
Pussy motherfucker.
Yeah, he's saying, like, some stuff. I can't hear him, though. We gotta turn it up.
So the other thing is, some of the swears are associated with your counter kill list that you have set up.
Okay.
So it's like, if you do, like, counter kill number 4, he'll do, like, swears from swear pack number 4, I think.
Okay.
Give me a reason why I should trust him this time.
Swear pack number 4.
Well, it is true that Kamal has many enemies.
I can't believe they spent that much time on that, like, the swear game.
That's really funny. I'm glad they did it.
I mean, it's good, but,
it's
like,
a really fucking great idea.
Oh, I thought you were a bad guy.
I mean, if I ever made a game, there's a pretty decent chance I'd put in upgradable swears.
Alright, why don't you stand next to that, see if you die.
Yep.
You gotta do better than that!
It does nothing. Ooh, another helicopter.
Fuck! Aw, shit! Going down, Kamal!
Going down, Kamal.
It's so dumb. God
the man is to say the PS2 era was not powerful enough for fully context-sensitive swearing.
Oh no, Tony Yayo!
Where are you? Where are you? I gotta
I'm on the
you.
Ground. There's no, like, timer for me to die. It's just I'll just stay there until you revive me.
I need to let my arms grow back behind cover here.
Uh-huh.
There we go.
Fucking grenade!
Fucking grenade, is that what he said? Do I say fucking grenade now because I upgraded my swears?
Yeah, when you throw grenades, it'll be like, fucking grenade!
Ooh, I got the rocket launcher ammo. Does he say fucking rocket when I shoot it too?
You know, I'm not sure. I don't remember if he says anything whenever he fires rockets.
That would be really nice. Is he calling people a cocksucker now? Ooh.
Yeah. I mean, the XXX just went up by 3 points, so... Oh my god.
I have the Molotovs now.
Okay.
Alright, we are actually getting late on time here.
Yeah, we'll have to end this pretty soon.
Yeah, because we actually have to show, we have something new to show off here, so.
Yeah.
We should do it really quickly.
Yeah.
Go ahead and let's flip the TV over while we're doing that.
Yeah.
So, sorry for ending this stream a little prematurely here, but we actually have something fun to show you for next week.
Yeah.
Go ahead and tell them what we're doing here.
So, for next week, we're going to be streaming another multiplayer game, but this time we want to have the actual viewers be able to come in and play with us. So we're actually going to be playing Quake, or rather the free version, which is NQuake, which we should...
Yeah, so if we hit desktop here,
yep.
Boom. So NQuake is basically Quake World. It's the first Quake. They call it Quake 1. Yep. And you can play it online for free. And what's interesting about it is that we've set up a 99-player server for all of you guys to actually jump in and play with us. And it's actually so easy to install. I'm going to show you how to do it here right on stream.
Yeah.
So if you go to this nquake.com website, and Mike, if you can paste it in the chat so everybody can do it, you can actually follow along with me and install this. But we're doing it here so that for people who are coming later, they can do this.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll go ahead and you'll just click download.
Yeah, and this thing's entirely free.
Yeah, it's entirely free. There's nothing to do. There's like no toolbars or adware shit on it. Like, you just download it. So I'm going to go ahead, hit download.
It's actually on a desktop.
It's in and says it's going to start in 3 seconds.
Yeah.
We'll just go through the whole thing here.
Okay.
But as it comes in, what this is going to do is it's going to actually download all the files that you need to play this. And you might be asking, like, how can this be free?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the shareware version of Quake actually has enough of the assets that you can play full multiplayer with it.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, basically all the maps you want to play on multiplayer are third-party maps anyway.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, like, it sends all the assets to you, so you can play it for free.
The installation thing here is super simple, but, like, there is, like, one thing you just need. Yeah. This is what we want to... why we're showing this. We need to let you know that when you're installing this, there's like one thing you just have to watch out for.
So when you go, you know, you agree to the license, you download the files. On the mirror, be careful of this because one of these mirrors is down and it will say that no files download.
Yeah, so just go with the New York one.
Yeah, the New York mirror works really well.
Yeah.
If it fails on you, just restart the installer. You'll be good to go.
Yeah.
When you're in here, what's great about it is you get to set your movement keys, WASD, set your name. Yay, yo. And if you're a silly person that inverts the mouse, you can do that here, too.
Madness.
It's going to ask you what you want to install. If you want old school, don't install the higher-res textures. If you do...
Yeah.
Or if you're like, oh, this game is ugly, I need to look good, install these. I'm going to uncheck all of these just so it downloads
really
fast. Yeah,
Team Fortress and Clan Arena isn't going to be on the server, I believe, so...
No.
Yeah, so...
So we don't need those
files. If you just
want
to play with us, you don't need to install that stuff.
Yeah. But you can if you want to.
Yeah.
I would associate the Quake World files, and I'll show you why later. And then it's going to install the CNQuake. It says don't install in program files. I don't know what happens if you do, but just don't.
Just do what it says.
Yeah, just do what it says. And so now what it's going to do is it's actually going to go here and download everything for us, right? And this is great because, like, if we actually looked at other multiplayer games that we could play that have free versions out there, like Doom... And
yeah,
Descent.
Once you start getting into the older shooters and stuff, the installation and stuff really assumes that you know how to do a lot of, like, annoying shit. So, Quake, thankfully, is something that's, like, super simple.
And shout-outs to the guys that made NQuake here, because this installer basically does everything for you.
Yeah, there's, like, no other configuration you need to do,
and
aside from installing.
Yeah, and the fact is that, like, this is so easy to install. It's actually the most difficult part about this is telling people how to connect to our server.
Yeah.
We've actually been playing internally for a week, and why don't you go tell people who know nothing about Quake what it even means to play this game, because my perspective is, like, totally slanted.
Yeah, I am not a person who played a lot of Quake growing up. I played maybe a little bit of Unreal Tournament, but, you know, it's an arena shooter. To play Quake is to sometimes get on a really good streak of blowing up people with really well-placed rockets, and then sometimes you explode the second you spawn. But it's pretty great. Especially since we're going to... Our server limit? What's the player limit?
So we have the servers actually set to 99 players.
Yeah, I'm curious to see what would happen with those maps with 99 players. It would probably... be pretty interesting. Maps too.
Well, when you first spawn, because there's probably only like 32 player starts.
Yeah,
you'll like get 10 frags because every time you spawn, you'll telefrag
everybody
somebody.
Spawning you.
Yeah. So once this is done, all you have to do is go to your start menu, and it's called Quake World. Do I have the right one?
I think it's actually just NQuake.
No, it says Quake World.
It's Play Quake World.
So the first time you run it, it's going to ask you to associate these URLs. You want to set it as the default because we can send the URL in the chat.
Yeah.
You click it, and it should just run it. Now, we had some problems with Chrome, because Chrome doesn't like to do this, but
yeah.
If you just paste it in a run window, or like here, or you hit Windows R to run something.
Yeah. This isn't something you really need to worry about, but just in case. Yeah.
So I set it as a default.
Yeah.
And then, boom, we're in play, right? Mm-hmm. So I'll go ahead. Our server is game.dsvolition.com.
Yep.
So in here, if you just hit the tilde button, it opens up the console. We're kind of used to this for games, but
yeah.
You do connect game.dsvolition.com.
Uh-huh.
And you're actually playing Quake World with us.
You can also go to the, if you're going in like the server browser, we'll be in there too. But yeah
just so
connect game.dsvolition.com. That's our server.
Woo! I'm running really fast.
You know, we're going to be doing this for the stream next week, but if you want to...
Yeah, every day at lunch, we get on and play.
Yeah, every day at lunch, 12 o'clock Central, so 1 Eastern, and then, like, what, 10 o'clock Pacific?
Yeah. Some internal Volition people get on and play, so if you want to practice up and get good, you can do that.
So, yeah, this whole upcoming week, you can just jump in. Well, jump in whenever, maybe it'll be some other people, but yeah, during lunch... noon Central Time is usually when we're all playing, okay. So,
I'll go ahead and I'll return to the main menu. But let's say that you didn't know the console command to get in.
Yeah.
You could just hit multiplayer, and it will go ahead and update the servers for you. It'll ping all the servers. This takes longer, which is why I tell you just type in the server name. And we're just Volition Quake 1.
They can't see past the start screen. That might be a resolution thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's still really simple.
Yes.
So,
yeah. Let me see if I can run in a window, if that fixes it.
Maybe.
Does that fix it? No, it doesn't.
No.
Maybe not. I don't know. It's hard to tell because...
It's probably just the delay.
Okay.
There
we go. They can actually see inside the window.
Yeah.
All right, there we go. So, we'll go ahead and disconnect again.
Yep.
So you just go to multiplayer, and then it'll ping all the servers. Ours is at the very top, which we can't see because we're in
we're in a huge resolution window.
But just look for Volition Quake Free for All.
Yep.
Or if you remember our server's name, it's just connect game.dsvolition.com.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all you have to do, and you're playing with us or with whoever else is in the chat. So people are like, they don't know if their computers can handle Quake. This Quake thing ran on a Pentium 60 with no graphics
you
card.
You can have, like, an E-machine from 2000, and it would probably run this just fine.
Yep.
So.
So, yeah, I know we have, like, baller-ass PCs here, but, like...
Yeah, you do not need any kind of good PC to play this. You can be playing this on, like, a hunk of junk, really.
Is it taking the controller input?
I bet it's taking the controller input.
It's doing something right now.
Yeah.
So, anyway, let's go ahead and we'll quit this.
Mm-hmm.
Quit. And how do we go back to the stream?
Shift up.
So that's us. Yep. Okay, so yeah, that's our stream for this week.
Yeah, and if ever everybody likes doing the Quake stuff, we're probably going to do some more multiplayer stuff for everybody, or the viewers will be able to play with us as well. We'll probably get some other people in the office to play same time.
There's a couple of people in here that love playing
Quake.
Yeah,
there's a couple.
They're kind of good.
There's a couple pretty good Quake players here, but they'll probably be there too.
I'm pretty sure we'll run into some really good Quake players.
Oh god, I am not a great Quake player.
Your average Joey is asking, does it run on integrated? And yes, it does, as long as you have OpenGL. All integrated graphics drivers have OpenGL to them, so that's all you need.
Yeah, you don't need, like, anything to make this thing run.
Yeah.
It could probably run on a toaster if it had a string.
It could probably run on string cheese.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, guys. Well, thanks. Thank you for showing up. That's our stream for the week. Next week, exactly at this time, we will be playing Quake.
Mm-hmm.
It is a server that supports 100 players. We want to see you guys jump in there. Let's see what happens when you throw, like, 50 people in a Quake server.
Oh, God.
Don't forget to play with us at lunch every day.
And there was somebody asking, are we going to have larger maps? And yeah, we have
much larger maps in the rotation.
We have big
right
maps
now.
In the rotation too. So, and we can change them too. So.
Yep.
And yeah, again, I'm Josh Stinson.
Yeah, and I'm Alex Mejia.
And thanks for watching and see you next week.
See you, Quake. Yeah.
Pop off, bitch.